Road. Today is a really, really cool day because driving the Tomaso Pantera. I've always wanted to drive one of these, and thankfully, a very kind gentleman has said I can take this one for a spin. This particular model is 1972 American import. And of course, it has a V8 engine. It has the Ford Cleveland 351 5.8 litre, which produces about 380 brake horsepower. 5-speed transmission. Disc brakes all round. The Di Tomaso was a company founded by Alejandro Di Tomaso in 1959. He was a racing driver, and at one point he went race for the Maserati brothers in the 1950s. Like a lot of racing drivers at the time, he really, really wanted to build his own race car. He got that chance in 1959. He even built an F1 car for Frank Williams in 1970. But he didn't really get into mass production until he released the Mangusta. Now, the Mangusta was a great car, but it had quite a few flaws. The interior was cramped, and it was noted for very, very twitchy handling. So, 1971, they announced the Pantera. Which sounds like that. Now, the Pantera was an interesting project. Because Ford America wanted to build a supercar for the American market, but they didn't want to build it themselves. They quite liked the Mangusta, so they approached Di Tomaso and asked them, would you build a new car for the American market? And they really wanted to tap into the idea of an exotic Italian sports car. Because Di Tomaso, he established his factory in Modena, and he really wanted to go toe-to-toe with Ferrari and Lamborghini. So the easiest thing to do for him was to build a car and to get a V8 engine for the United States rather than develop his own complex and expensive V12. So Ford provided the engine, let's say the Cleveland V8, which is an absolute beast of an engine. Engines go, it's very reliable, very simple, and nowhere near as complicated as a Lamborghini V12 or a Ferrari V12. So it makes it a lot easier to live with, and of course it means you get that noise, which is just epic. I'm probably going to say the word epic quite a lot on this drive. Probably the word awesome as well, so I apologise in advance for sounding like a bit of a drooling idiot. But it really does feel awesome. Now, when Di Tomaso launched the Pantera in 1971, it was very well received. They built over 7,000 of these cars. Production finally ended in 1991, so it was around for a long time, for a lot longer than the Lamborghini Countach. The funny thing with Panteras is, a lot of people don't know about them. If you're a true petrolhead, if you're really into your cars, yes, you'll know about a Pantera. But most people on the street, they see one of these, they don't know what it is. Makes all that bit more interesting. One of the things I find amazing with this car . It was designed in the 60s, but it feels like a modern car in a way. Yes, it's very mechanical and it's not as refined obviously as a modern car, but in terms of performance it's absolutely amazing. not bad. I think it's alright. The gear shift is really nice. It's a classic gated shifter. Comfortable car as well. It's got electric windows, which is nice. As standard, they came with air conditioning. This one doesn't have air conditioning working at the moment. The pump has been taken off, so that needs fixing, but who cares? Visibility in the cockpit, it's okay. You're quite close to the windscreen, which really enhances the sense of speed. You can look out the rear window, which is a major, major plus. It's better than a Lamborghini in that respect. Okay, first gear. Everything I own to buy one of these. I'll think about it.